audience, young students, ladies and gentlemen. I'm very happy to be a part of the second event organized by this NGO. I was with them when this event was organized at the Shulani University. And since then, on this topic, in the university, different departments of the university have focused on this issue of biodiversity. During the first meeting, we had discussed and decided that we would do something more meaningful to progress this agenda. I reminded my colleagues of that agenda, but we have been slow in moving in that direction. So what is the agenda? Agenda is looking at our own survival. And it is not survival of India, but the agenda is global. It is survival of world globally in the context of worrying about Himalayan ecology. And what is the importance of Himalayas? So we all look at the world map, okay? And the world map is a two-dimensional projection of a sphere, our hemisphere. And we are used to looking at it north-south, okay? You can look at the Google map, each one of you can do it by the smartphone, and you just turn it by 90 degrees. Don't look at it, same map is there, just turn it by 90 degrees. And now expand it and sort of put it on a proper dimension that Himalayas is in the middle of that map. So it's a little away from the equator. So what is Earth? So 2 pi r. Okay, at the equator you have 24,000 miles. Okay, we are a little bit away. So it's maybe 18,000 miles. And what is Himalayas as a range? It's about 3,000 miles away. Okay, so now imagine that Homo sapiens started from Africa. Okay, we discussed this topic in geology department on a geological time scale. Then we have looked at it in the Department of Environmental Science in the past 100 years only. And what is past 100 years? Past 100 years is two wars, great advances in science and technology, and in the background of that science and technology is, you know, molecular basis of everything. In the background of radioactivity to atomic theory, then it is a molecular basis of life sciences. This is where your all gene banks is starting. So now, this 3,000 miles of Himalayas, okay? So everything is, so what is Himalayas? It's, you know, movement of things, and Himalayas is an artificial creation in the background of things happening on geological time scale. And this is Himalayas, and this Himalayas is now controlling your all weather system. Okay, the weather system, you know, this is the Somalia cloud formation starts, and all Indian monsoon is all that monsoon clouds reaching up to the Himalayas. And Himalayas is not just for South Asia, but Himalayas is also for the North Asia. That is why I said, look at the thing, map, right in a right-angled way. So movement of people, you know, starting from Africa, and Chinese look different from us. So somewhere there is bifurcation has happened, again because of this 3,000 miles of Himalayas. And Himalayas is not only controlling things in South Asia, but you know, there are also rivers flowing in China. And about 50% of the population is just around Himalayas of the globe. So this is, and all this, these issues have come up by just 100 years of science and technology in past 100 years. And that science and technology, great advances have happened after the Second World War because you are trying to control the political economy of the world. If the Western nations trying to control the political economy of the world, in the background of that is all this space research. In the background of space research is growth in research which led to computers, communications. Once there is a computer, communications, then there is a cell phone, then there is an internet, and there is a globalized economy, there is a knowledge-based economy in which the rest of the world is also now participating. Everybody who gets educated, okay, is a part of this globalized economy because it's a knowledge-based economy, and that is not, no, it is not going being controlled by one race. It's not that Anglo-Saxon. Everybody is there. This corporatization of the world is has to be looked in. So Himalayan economy, I mean Himalayan, worrying about the Himalayan ecology is worrying about the survival of human beings on the surface of the earth. So this is what the agenda is. So the politicians are not going to worry about it, because the politicians have to win elections. Every 3 years they have to go and, you know, this is what you are worrying about. This regulatory regime, that regulatory regime, so they have to say. So who should worry about this? It is my personal belief, this job has to be done by the university teachers, who in the present system, if it survives, they have jobs for life. Once you get a job as a university teacher, then it's a job for life. You are not transferred. Political parties come and go. States are there. But they get different states, there are different political parties. But universities per se are somewhat insulated from all these things that happen on a short-term basis. So I believe the university teachers across the state boundaries must assume responsibility to worry about these topics on a long-term basis. This is what we discussed, I believe, when we had the first meeting in children. I think we must progress towards that. The inter-university consortiums in this 6-7 states, which are for part of the northwest of India. Now there is a northeast of India. We should also imagine the northwest of India. Government of India, you know, proposes so many things for the northeast of India. Nobody proposes things for the northwest of India. So northwest of India is the 7 states of India with Chandigarh as a capital. So this is where the Punjab University comes in. And the Punjab University must assume responsibility of creating and getting all the universities together to worry about the 7 states which are the northwest of India. Punjab, Haryana, Himachal, Western UP, Uttarakhand, Jammu, and even Western Rajasthan, where you are wanting to take canals from the rivers of Punjab. And Satluj Yamuna link canal, see what is it? There are some rivers starting from the same Himalayan thing which are going to flow into the Arabian Sea via Pakistan. And then Yamuna is a bifurcation, and then there are rivers via the northern plains, they are going to flow into the Bay of Bengal. And yet Yamuna, Satluj Yamuna link was trying to do something, so that one river system is to be connected to the other system, river system, so that the prosperity and well-being of everyone can be ensured. Without worrying about the state boundaries, political party affiliations, blah, 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 and so on. So this is a thing, it is a need of the hour. The earlier you commence that process, create this, it's not, I don't think we should look up to Justice Swatantra Kumar to give us directives that we should form groups. We should do it on our own. Okay. And seek his help when his term gets over, that he also returns back to the university. He is part of this thing. So it is not that while he holds this position that he should be a part of it. No. He should be a part of it as long as he can contribute to it. So I can go on and on, but I am looking forward to listen to his final remarks as to how we should go about doing it. Thank you very much.